Thank you, Jesus. Let's lift our hands to the Almighty God as we want to bless the name of the Lord in this song. Thank you, Jesus. I know that the Lord will touch many of us today in Jesus' name. As many that have come to meet with the Lord, I know that His righteousness will be upon our lives in Jesus' name. Amen. As we lift our hands to the Almighty God, I want to say thank you to the Almighty. And as you're thanking the Lord, then I want to thank the Lord from the bottom of your heart. Thank you, Jesus. I am saying thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, my Lord.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For every family here, we thank you. For every man here, we thank you. For everybody here, we say thank you, Jesus. God bless you, Lord. We give you praise. We give you all of you. We thank you for that. We thank you because you're a good God. You have never failed. You will never fail. The Bible says you are the same yesterday. You are the same today. You are the same forever. You are a God that has not failed. You are the prayer answering God. You are the Jehovah Hell Shaddai. You are the Jehovah Rapha. You are the unchangeable changer. You are the beginning. You are the ending. You are the one that opens and no one can close. You are the one that closes and no one can open. You are the great I am that I am. You are the unchangeable Lord. The Lion of the tribe of Judah. The Lady of the Valley. The Rose of Sharon. The one that will be forever. Who is that going to be? Glory be to you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In louder, amen. Now before you sit down, I want to take this prayer louder here, stretching your right hand to the heavens. Stretching your right hand to the heavens. Stretching your right hand to the heavens. Wherever you are connected with us, I want to open your mouth also and pray along with us. Everybody cry louder here. Say, every stubborn stretching their trust towards your altar and not unto any man. Father, I decree you are the God of all flesh. I decree that every hard situation, every hard problem that has accompanied your children unto this sanctuary, as they stretch their two hands towards you, Lord, Father, I ask you will give them an answer in Jesus' name. I said you will give them an answer in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give you an answer in the name of Jesus. Mysterious problem that you don't know the source. Every mysterious occurrence that has crippled you, the one that has crippled your doctors, I command them to receive solution. Let your enemy run fire. Receive solution. 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 I have a word for somebody today. That the power that have printed your obituary for this month, they have said that they don't want to see you alive. I decree right now, they shall die in your place. 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 They shall die. They shall die. They shall die. By fire. They shall die. They shall die. In the name of Jesus. Report. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I decree and I declare to somebody, wherever they have made your image, wherever they have summoned your spirit man, because you are supposed to abide under the shadow of the Almighty, I decree and I declare, I will draw you by fire. I will draw you right there. I will draw you. I will draw you. And your soul, and they are toying around with it. They think they can do anything with you. Listen, you are a child of God. The one who doesn't touch not my anointing and do my prophet God. Stretch your two arms towards the altar. The angels of God are here. I decree every grave that they have put you in, I drag you out. I drag you out. I drag you out. Listen to the word of God. Somebody here, you know the person you offended? You know the person very well. The person said that over is on our dead body, will you go free? I want to decree right now, let your amen be loud and clear. Father, I decree and I declare unto your children that are here, I decree that any power said over is on our dead body, will this one make progress? I command the ground to swallow them. Every stubborn power that they say that you are going to this church, you are going to mountain of fire, I will see the end of your life. I say it is a lie. You shall see your head. 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 In the name of Jesus. I decree by the decree of God that any evil word, any evil letter, any evil decree that has been written with a witchcraft pen in the demonic wall, I cancel it now! I cancel it! I cancel it! I cancel! I cancel! I cancel! I cancel! I cancel! I cancel it! In the name of Jesus! Let me hear seven amen! Yes! And I cover that prayer with the blood of Jesus. You are a child of God, and I know that the Lord Almighty is interested in you. Any other power that want to take and control your affairs, or they want to change that which God has written for you, they shall Almighty be buried out. The Lord will strengthen you. In Jesus' name we pray. To the Lord, amen. Before you sin, I want to go to Samuel and tell you that any power that will confront you this month shall be buried alive. In the name of Jesus, make sure you are seven in number. Any power that will confront you this month shall be buried alive. Open your mouth and say to seven people. Shall be buried alive. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You are all welcome in Jesus' name. And I thank the Lord Almighty for your life. I know that the Lord will continue to strengthen you in Jesus' name. And I know that the Lord who has brought you here will continue to hold you and your families in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the Lord. I want to listen to this short message before we go into our Thanksgiving service. And I know that the Lord will touch each and every one of us in Jesus' name. And I will talk about your vision and your destiny helpers. Your vision and your what?
Destiny.
Let me say it again. Your vision and your
destiny.
Many of you that have heard the message earlier on during the previous months, you have heard me talk about your vision, isn't it?
Yes.
And I said that you must have a vision.
Yes, sir.
But apart from you having your vision for this very year, Many of you will understand with me now that 1 month has gone out of 12, isn't it? So if you were to do a calculation of the whole year, it is remaining 11 over 12, isn't it? Because one has gone already. Praise the name of the Lord. After having your vision, I'm not going to talk about the vision in detail, but if you want to listen to that, you can go and watch the previous videos. After having your vision, you also need a helper. Tell somebody you need a helper. Now, you're not saying like you're somebody. They tell you need a helper. Everybody needs a helper. Everybody needs what? So let's open our Bible to the book of Luke, chapter 22. And I want to read the Bible verse very clearly. Luke 22, let's read from verse 7 to 15. And let all the ushers help me make sure that there is what I call absolute order. Thank you, Jesus. Let there be order, and let the parents also take care of the children. Thank you, Jesus. Luke 22, verse 7 to 15. Luke 22, verse 7 to 15. Thank you, Jesus. Are we there now? Let's read together. Let's go. Let's go. Then came the day of unleavened bread, when the Passover must be killed. And he sent Peter and John. Are we reading the same thing?
Yes.
Okay, let's go together now. We're agreeing to verse 8. Let's go. And he sent Peter and John, saying, God, prepare us the Passover that we may eat. Verse 9 now. Where will thou that we prepare? Verse 10, let's go. Behold, when ye are entered into the city, there shall a man meet you, bearing a pitcher of water. Follow him into the house where he entered in. Verse 11, let's go. Of the house. The master said unto thee, where is the guest chamber, where I shall eat the Passover with my disciples? Verse 12. Upper room, furnished, there made ready. And 13, let's go now. And they made ready the Passover. Tell someone, did you read that part of the Bible? Ask the person, let me hear you now. Praise the name of the Lord. It was the Passover time, isn't it?
Yes.
And they needed a guest room. They needed a place where they would do it. But hearing the word of God saying, go and meet someone. Because they didn't have it. Because they didn't know what? And they had an ask. The master told them, they met it like that. The master said, did not have it. But they needed a helper. Tell somebody, you need a helper. Now I can hear your voice. Tell the person, let me hear you now. The Bible says in Psalm 121, verse 1, it says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, which made the heavens and the earth. Now, your vision and your destiny helper go together. Let me say it again. Your vision and your what? Just what? Go together. So everyone that is here, you need a destiny helper. Tell somebody, you need a destiny helper. Let the person hear you loud and clear. And for the benefit of those that may not understand what I'm saying, what exactly is your destiny? Let me go from there. Your destiny is what God has created it to be. It's divine purpose. It's divine what?
Purpose.
Destiny is actually your original assignment. If they drop you here and they say, Brother Joseph or Brother Bartholomew, whatever your name will be, you are going to be dropped on earth. The original reason you are dropped is your what?
Destiny.
Your destiny is the original plan of God for you. It's what I call your predetermined future. It is what I call your God's given agenda or God's agenda for your life. Your destiny is also what you ought to be in life. Your destiny is what God has designed and proposed for you. So if you are doing what is contrary to that, that means you are not fulfilling destiny, isn't it? Your destiny is what I call the predestined. predetermined paths for your life before you were born. They predetermined what? Paths for your life before you were born. Before you came here. God said, before I formed you, I knew you, even from your mother's womb. Before you were even formed. Your destiny is what I call the divine blueprint. It's the roadmap. It's the natural course of events that has been planned by God that will inevitably happen. It will definitely happen. I pray that any power on assignment to paralyze your destiny shall be destroyed by fire. 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 Now, before the foundation of the earth, the Lord had a plan. The Lord had what? And he had a plan for yourself. He had a plan for myself. It's very, very vital that we understand it very well. Sometimes it may be that you have not gotten to that place, just like Joseph, or brother Joseph, who never got to the place, but God had a plan that it will be number two in Egypt. At the time, I say your destiny will not be truncated in the name of Jesus. Now, some facts I'd like you to understand clearly is that destined helpers are also divine helpers that have been orchestrated by heaven for you. They've been what? Orchestrated by what? Heaven for you. It's not just that it wasn't just that they just came. No. God has already prepared them for your life. Who are these divine helpers? Number one, there's someone that has been divinely programmed by God to move you to your next level. To move you to your what? Is somebody that has been used or that will be used to take you to fulfill your destiny in life. You need to understand that very well. A divine helper is a person that has been prepared by heaven to provide help to you where you need help. And that help is one single help that will change your life forever. And you will know that, you will never forget that person. And you will never forget that death. The person may come as a woman, it may come as a man, it may come as old, it may come as young. Bottom line is that it will do one particular thing and that changes the course of your life. Lift your right hand to the heavens and you will shout this loud and clear. My destiny helpers! Where are you? Appear! In the name of Jesus! God bless you, take your seat, the Lord will strengthen you. The destiny helper and your divine helper is a person that plays a divine role in your life at a particular period. Listen to what I said last. A person that plays a divine role in your life at a particular what? Period. That's a chamber that was wanted by the Lord. They wanted to go and have what I call the Passover, isn't it? They were looking for a place to use. They needed somewhere to use. And they got a place. So that place was used. And that's why the Bible records it very well in Luke chapter 22, verse 7 to 15. Clearly telling us that person was used very year. There is a destiny helper for you. What matters most that? Do you understand? Do you recognize it? And are you waiting for it? Let me say it again. Do you understand it? Are you ready for it? And are you also waiting for it? I pray that your destiny helper, your divine helpers will locate you in Jesus' name. Now listen again very well. Your destiny helper will always connect you to the top. Let me say it again. Your destiny helper will always what? It will always connect you to move to another stage in your life, not connecting you to the bottom. Your destiny helper will always facilitate your destiny. Always what? Facilitate your what? I can tell you that Great Britain does not make friends with just anybody. Great Britain makes friends with people that will move them to the next. If that president will not know, they don't share, they won't associate. They will do like they don't know him. When they see the person that will move them to the next, they will connect. Isn't it? You and I, we know that. So if a whole Great Britain needs help, who are you? Who am I? That will only be destiny what? They don't go for just anybody. They will not go for just anyone. If you see them in a place, you will know that there's something there. There is something there. If that thing is still buried under the ground or in the water, it's only a matter of time you will know. They don't connect with just anybody. So your destiny helper must be someone that will take you to the next world. Thank you, Jesus. Just a minute, are you listening to Pastor? Are you listening to Pastor? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for helping me to tell them. Your destiny helper will still come to have value to your life. They will have what? Your destiny helpers are those that will go out of their way to help you. They will go out of what? Most of the time, they don't require anything in return. They will just be there at that time. They will help you. And that is it. And they go away. And you may never see them again, ever. Like a long time ago, I told you, when I came to the United Kingdom for the first time, I came with two big, and the third bag was big. And somebody had told me that you would just enter a train and it would be easy. I didn't know it was going to be easy. I was going to go on a step, and one guy came from nowhere. I was wondering, how am I going to carry this thing? The guy just told me, do you need help to carry this? And I said, yes. When they carried it, I was saying, you must be God sent. He didn't stop there. He said, where am I going again? I told him, he said, well, I'll take you there. He took me there. I was wondering. We traveled for close to 1.5 hours until they got to where I was. He took me out. He said, stay there. And I said, don't worry. And he disappeared. I can't forget him because I can't see him again to say thank you. I can't see him out. He just helped me at that very point in time. And I cannot forget that, but I can tell you. Lift your right hand again to the heavens. Shout his love out there. Say, my destiny helper! Say it up. My sister, open your mouth and pray a prayer. You are not joking here. Jesus is here. Command your helper to appear. To appear. Aha. In Jesus' name, you pray. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Take your seat. Your destiny helper will help you to navigate through all obstacles. Through what? Your destiny helper will help you to succeed. Either in your career, in your family, in your business, whatever you're doing, it will help you to succeed. I remember a sister told me, Pastor, I got the job. Hey, Pastor, I got the job. See, I only applied and I went to the interview and I don't know anything. I laughed. So you don't know anything. So they were asking everything. They asked all the questions, and the bad things are they gave her the job. She said, Pastor, they gave me the job. I said, the fire they gave me the job, you must go there. Tell somebody you must go there. You must go there. So we said a simple prayer. Say, Father Lord, let I meet a destiny helper on that job. You know, when she just arrived in this, she was just looking. They were saying everything. She was just nodding at him. You don't know anything. So somebody just said, I see that you seem to be very good, calm. You know, she was just saying, you seem to look humble. I've not done anything to look humble here. And don't worry, I'm going to teach you. I'm going to be going to America very soon. I'll teach you. And the person was teaching them like a baby. Doesn't know how to press this. Doesn't know how to press that. For 3 weeks. In fact, she said, I told her, tell him that you don't know it.
When they say, don't worry, we don't know how to teach you. Immediately, for 3 weeks, was taught. The guy left the company. Left. Final. It remained the sister of God. Says, Pastor, I will do all the things that the guy said. I will just go back again, read it over and over and over. And she kept being there every time. In fact, what she said that, Pastor, if I lose this job, I don't think I can get this girl to do it again, ever. But she could not forget that person. That's a disclaimer waiting there. Even when you don't know anything. Lift your hand and give one more time. You shall want to shout with fire. Say, wherever my destiny helper is. A destiny helper to Moses, isn't it? What's that in the Bible? From Genesis chapter 18. He went to Moses on his own. He advised Moses. He did a lot of things for Moses, if you read the Bible. Another one is that you see that the butler, that's the butler and that baker, those two guys in the prison to Joseph, they were destiny helpers to Joseph. They were what? Destiny helpers. If you read the Bible very well, you discover that you just need only one destiny helper. Let me say it again. Only what? And it changes the course of your life forever. And also, the same thing goes on the other side, which we're not going to talk about today. You also need only one destiny demolisher. Only one to change the course of your life again and the person begin to go down. Only one, you don't need two. But that is for another day in Jesus' name. But that destiny one that will take you to the next level is only one. It's only what? It will change everything for. And most of the time they will come for a particular purpose at a particular time. Most of the time when they have done their assignment, they leave. Let me say it again, they what? They disappear. You may not see them again forever. In fact, to pay them back may be difficult. Maybe what? Naaman and the maid kept saying, oh, my master, I should go and see the man of God, isn't it? Yeah. Oh, my master, go and see the man of God. But the question is that the maid was a destiny of God, isn't it? The Bible told us that Naaman was a captain of the host of the army, but he was a leper. He was a general. He had all the ranks. He had won a lot of battles, isn't it? He had lots of horses, all men, lots of men behind him. The Bible said, but he was the what? Thank God he listened to the advice of the maid. Elijah and the widow of Zarephath. It was clearly that the widow of Zarephath was just a divine helper at that particular what? Time. And you can also see Mordecai and Esther. The same thing happened there. Even Eli and Hannah. Hannah was crying for a child. On that day, the Lord, Eli said, so be it. Let your prayers be what? Answered. I pray for somebody today. Yeah, your destiny helper, wherever they are in the whole world, whether they're in Australia, whether they're in America, whether they're in South America, whether they're in Africa, in any part of Europe, I command to locate you, my child. Let your enemy walk in fire. To locate you. 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 Take your seat. Now, there are different kinds of categories of this destiny helper. There are number one, advisors. They are what? Advisors. You just tell them, ah, sister, don't go that way. This is the way. And they can leave. And they can what? They just leave. Number two, there are counselors. They can counsel you and say, that's not the way to do. And they will tell you, it's either you take it at that time or not. If you listen to that advice, it becomes easy for you. It becomes what? Very easy. A long time ago when I came to the UK, I came on holiday like I told you. I met a young man
He said, Eddie, he said, yeah, it's good. Yeah, you can, I mean, you can be in London if you wanted to. It's 2 weeks. One way is you come as a legal. One way you be a legal. Isn't it? He gave me the simple. And he says, the legal one is very easy. Did he go to university? I said, yes. Do you have a master here? Do you have this? Yes. He said, well, go to the internet, check something, and maybe you can do it, and then maybe they'll give you residence. Simple. What? Simple. In fact, he was telling me at Houston train station. I cannot forget that. It's one thing for me to receive it, take it in my head, carry my bag, went back to Nigeria, isn't it? But when I got there, I checked what this man said. I said, I checked it. I googled it. I looked everywhere. I filled the form. Sent it to the home office. He just sent me back my paper from there. I didn't know anybody. It was just a simple guy that told me, do this, and I did it. So somebody can tell you something. A counselor can give you a good counsel. And that is how you was. And that counsel can be very good for your life. So don't throw them away. And they are also destiny what? Helpers. Number three, good informants and good friends. They can be also what? Destiny helpers. Number four, mentors. Those that will advise you. Number five, the workers. The workers of the church. Just like the apostles, they supported Jesus Christ. They can do what? Destiny what? Number seven, unsolicited supporters. What are you talking about? Unsolicited what? Somebody was just talking about David in the palace to the helper. Let me say it again. Somebody was talking about what? David in the palace to what? David did not canvass for help, isn't it? But somebody was there in the palace. Say, I know a boy that will play the instrument and the devil will flee away from the king, isn't it? Or the spirit, the evil spirit will what? Somebody needs to talk about you. But what are they saying? Are they saying positively or negatively? So everybody needs a divine helper who will speak for you even where you did not get to. If you're not going to get to the helpers, say this loud and clear. Say, my father. Raise a voice for me in the palace of my helper. In the name of Jesus, my father, raise a voice in the palace of my helper. Open your mouth and shout louder. Raise a voice. Raise a voice. Oh Lord, my father, raise a voice. Raise a voice. Raise a voice for me in the palace of my helpers. Raise a voice for me. In Jesus' name, we pray. Put your hands on God's seat. I will continue from there in Jesus' name. But listen to me carefully. You need a helper. You need what? Whether the one that you solicited for or the one that you did not solicit for, you need a what? An example also of an unsolicited supporter. Is a man that was going on the was going to meet his plane on F-25. The taxi he took messed up there. He had paid for taxi, isn't it? So the taxi messed up on the road. So they brought out their bags on the highway on the F-25. How many of you have ever stopped on F-25? You will never stop, isn't it?
Yeah.
But here comes a guy, he just pulled down behind them. He said, I see you have a bag. Are you going to Gatwick or Heathrow? I can take you. And they took them there. The guy was freezing, saying, my God. And he's going to miss his plane, number one. He's going to pay another money, number two. He has checked out of the hotel. He was thinking, oh, it was calculated. But somebody drove and came behind him. Unsolicited. Isn't it?
Yeah.
On what? You can't wave anybody down. M25, everybody is just blocked off in wheel. Everybody on high, isn't it? So, and the guy came there, carried the bag into his own car, and took the guy straight to the airport, and the guy did not miss his flight. And he's still wondering, where is this guy? Who is this guy? Where has he gone to? He's an helper that God sent. Lift your hands and give to them. Say, my father! Send me a divine helper! In the name of Jesus! Open your mouth with fire!
must understand that you have a divine assignment first. Notice again, you have a divine what?
Assignment.
That you must know that I am this and I have a divine. Number two, you must know that you cannot continue to live in sin and God will send your helper to you. It's not going to be possible. They don't work together. They don't what? So you can't be spoiling somebody or spoiling somebody's business or attacking somebody's marriage and you want God to send a divine helper to you. You're just a joker. That's not what we're talking about here. So you must understand. So drop every known and unknown sin. You can't be an evil broadcaster to somebody else and you want somebody to broadcast you in Buckingham Palace. You're just a liar. A big what?
Liar.
Or God to send a divine helper. No. You can't be spoiling somebody, living in sin, and you want God to what? It does not work like that. So you must repent from all wrong and wrong sin. Number three is that you must pray what I call an inquiry prayer. That Lord, why am I here? And where is my helper? Why am I here? And where is my what? You must also pray your helper to appear. That your helper will know no peace until he buys a ticket and say, I just want to go to London. I just want to go to London. I don't know why. And he gets to London. He gets there and says, I just want to go to East London and come and meet you. Until he meets you, and over whatever he needs to do, he will not have rest. I pray for somebody today that your helper will not have rest until they help you. Until they help you. Until they help you. A season of sleeplessness. A what? Many of you don't know that kind of prayer. Those prayers belong to some people. Okay? If you have an enemy and you don't want to sleep, you want to withdraw their sleep, there's some prayers that the person will never sleep until they do what you want them to do. So, if you have a helper or you think your helper has not come and God has told you there's an helper that will come, and you have not seen it, you better begin to pray that that helper will not lose sleep until he arrives and locates you. And you discover that immediately the helper does what the assignment is being called from heaven to do. He will have peace, he will go away, you will have peace, you begin to fulfill your destiny. Thank you, Jesus. Now, you must also avoid what I call destiny diluters. Let me say it again. Destiny what? There are so much. There's so much. And that's now a bigger topic for another day. Destiny diluters are so much in the Christendom, in the church. They have the same face like you and I. They dress like you and I. But they are taking us nowhere. They're taking us what?
Nowhere.
The easier way is quickly identify them and run. And what? Resist the devil. He will flee from you. Begin to harbor the devil. He will cling to you like what? So the earlier you identify them, does what? Let there be a serpent and their destiny diluters. I pray that you will not meet destiny diluters. Your amen is not loud.
You will not miss destiny diluters in the name of Jesus.
An example of destiny killers, Herod. He killed all the children 2 years on the Bible, isn't it? Was a destiny killer. Sambalat and Tobiah. They were destiny killers. Go and look at their accounts in the Bible. Their destiny what? They are not ready for anything. They can finish anyone and they can destroy. Those that talk too much, they are destiny diluters. Anybody that talks too much, just run away. Just what? Just run away. Because both the things that are right and are wrong and that are not accounted and that are false, it will be telling you. Or she will be telling you. And if anybody is already coming to tell you about A, B, C, D, oh,
mean that your own matter is also there. You be a big F-O-O-M to assume that he is telling me everything. She loves me. He loves me. He's telling me everything. This one seems to be helping me. Oh, the father is telling me everything. Your matter is zero. Because your matter is everywhere. Everywhere. It's painted everywhere. So if anybody's telling you a lot of things, he has a lot of news, a lot of information, he can tell you this, both that is right and that is wrong. Even sometimes, you yourself, you doubt it. But you can't tell him, say, shut up, my Mr. Man, this is false. Or, shut up, Mr. Woman, this is false. You are respecting him, or you are respecting her. You yourself, you know, the fact that you have been knowing, you better run. You better what? You'll be a big F-O-L to Stevie and say, he is my friend, he is the one, he or she is the one. You'll be deceiving yourself because they are destiny diluters. They will have finished you long before you realize and say, hey, so what was I doing this? So how was I been doing this? How have I been? I pray that they will not come your way. Yeah. Let me hear me wrong. They will not come your way. If you have never surrendered your life to Christ, you have an opportunity this morning. The Bible says, "Verily, verily, I say, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." The Bible says, "For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." The Bible says, "And their sins and iniquity will I remember no more." All eyes closed, all heads bowed. You want to surrender your life to Christ this morning? Before we go to our prayers. You have an opportunity right now. Those of you that are watching me, wherever you're watching me from, in the whole world, you want to surrender your life to Christ. Jesus is here. Today is a day of salvation. Tomorrow may be too late. So wherever you want to surrender your life to Christ, I want to give you an opportunity right now. Just put your right hand on your chest. Every one of you that wants to surrender your life to Christ, put your right hand on your chest as I pray for you. For those that are putting your right hand on your chest, let's say this prayer loud and clear. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Forgive me my sins. Beginning from today, I say bye-bye to the world. Beginning from today, I am born again. Write my name in the book of life. Forgive me completely all my iniquities. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. If you have said that short prayer with me, the Lord Almighty will write your name in the book of life in Jesus' name. And he will also forgive you your sins in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for your children who have surrendered their life to Christ this morning. I ask you that you will touch their lives in Jesus' name. On the last day, when you make the roll call, they will not be found wanting in Jesus' name. They will be seated with you, Almighty, at your right hand, in heavenly places, in the name of Jesus. The word says, if we regard iniquity in the heart, that the Lord will not hear us, but Lord Almighty, this was Almighty, ask for forgiveness. Father, forgive them completely in Jesus' name. When they begin to pray, that is today, answer them by fire in the name of Jesus. And let your name be glorified. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. In louder, amen. Amen. All eyes closed, all heads bowed. Beloved, we want to take some 7 prayer points. Because our divine destiny helpers must locate us. Amen. We must not miss them. Amen. And I pray that the Lord will touch our lives in Jesus' name. Amen. Everybody says louder here. Say, my destiny helpers. Yeah. To be here now, let your spirit, soul, and body be here right now. Thank you, Jesus. Say, every power contending with my divine helpers. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Aha. 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 Yes. To that. To that. To that. To that. To that. In Jesus' name, we pray. Number three prayer, beloved, I want you to roar with fire and with thunder. And as I pray, I know that the Lord will fight your battles in Jesus' name. Yes. Satanic opportunity contenders.
Satanic opportunity contenders.
Let me hear you say it again.
Satanic opportunity contenders.
What are you doing in my life? Thank you, Jesus. No, pray number four, pray loud and clear. Listen, you want to remove every hindrance on the way of your helper. Have you not discovered? Open your eyes now. Have you not discovered yourself? Sometimes you want to help somebody. You want to help, but you just did not do it. In your heart, you did want to help, but the opportunity did not come. Is that the very something went wrong somehow and you could not help the person, isn't it? Close your eyes now. You want to pray that any barrier in front of your helper, it must cut out.
Amen.
It must what?
Scatter.
Whatever the barrier is that is troubling your helper, that barrier must cut out because your helper must locate you.
Amen.
Your helper must what?
Amen.
You will cry loud and say, invisible barrier! So when the helper comes, they don't see us. They actually come. God send them. But when they see you, they see invisible. They see something different. Because the garment of darkness is actually upon you. What I'm saying is not a physical garment. I'm talking about a spiritual garment. All eyes closed. Beloved, you pray this prayer for yourself loud and clear. Say, garments
of darkness.
With destiny diluters, destiny helpers cannot touch you. It's like somebody being under a satanic umbrella and is looking for the rain of the Lord. It's not going to touch. They will not touch. Close your eyes. You want the fire of God to separate you and destiny diluters. They must go. They must go. Let them go out of your life.
Catch me from destiny diluters. Now let me hear you say it again.
My destiny helper. Wherever you are. As your servant this very morning, that everyone connected to us, everyone that is saying amen, everyone that is here in spirit and in truth, that needs a helper. Father, release your helper in the name of Jesus. Release your helper. From your helper to locate you, I command that veil to catch fire. 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 Every visible and invisible force that is assigned to hinder you from getting great connection, that is assigned to hinder you from getting great destiny helpers, I command that attraction to be directed. To lift you up. I command that wall to crumble now. Let the wall crumble. Let the wall crumble. Let the wall crumble. Let the wall crumble. Every spirit of antagonism that has been assigned against your destiny and to hinder you from getting help, every satanic antagonistic power, every antagonism assigned against you, whether in your family, whether in the church, whether among your friends, whether in your office, or among your business managing partners, I command that antagonism to expire. 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 Your destiny helpers will locate you. They 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 will locate you.
I shall never relocate you.
If they have been held down in the prison of life, wherever they are in the whole world.
I release them by fire. I release them. 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 In the name of Jesus.
Daddy, we thank you. We bless your name. We give you all the glory. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Let me hear seven loud amen.